Hi, Todd Warren here in the Forecast Center with a look at our weather week ahead here on ArchitectsHomepage.com as well as the ArchitectsHomepage.com weather app, or I should say news app. And you can see that we do have a flash flood watch that is in effect for a good chunk of the Architects, East Texas, all of Northwest Louisiana, as well as Columbia County there in Southwest Arkansas. These areas are where the heaviest rain likely will continue to fall during the course of the next several days, as this flash flood watch does continue through Wednesday. In addition to that, later on this afternoon, we'll be watching for a few strong thunderstorms, mainly over the southern sections of the Architects. You can see where we do have a slight risk, according to the Storm Prediction Center. So far, so good. We haven't seen much as far as any severe thunderstorms as of yet, but there's going to be a window later on this afternoon as well as during the early evening hours Monday where we might see a strong thunderstorm or two, mainly over the south part of the area. As we work our way north into the cooler air, that risk does not appear to be too much of a concern. As far as the conditions we'll be watching for, wind, probably the biggest concern. A stray tornado could be possible. Can't totally be ruled out, but that risk is looking low. And of course, we do have the relatively high risk for some flash flooding across the area, hence the flash flood watch, which is currently in effect across the region. Here's the setup as we have, again, a front, which is straight draped across the heart of the Architects. There's that upper level low we mentioned late last week, which has dived basically settled into Baja California right now. And it is sending a lot of moisture our way and will continue to do so until Wednesday, when this finally will move past. We'll see a bit of a break for Thursday, Friday, and then another disturbance will kind of settle into the western sections of the country. And that'll give us more rain, more than likely, starting late Saturday, with much of that rain holding off until Sunday. Now, the main weather feature to watch here for the next couple of days will be this cold front. And this frontal system will play a big role on the amount of severe weather that we see. Most models easing it to the south here during the course of the next 24 hours and probably keeping it there. It may work its way northward just a little bit Wednesday, but it looks like Wednesday will stay far enough to the south and east that it'll keep most of the severe weather to the south and east of the Architects for Wednesday as that main upper level disturbance moves in. But keep in mind, if it does move further to the north, if we do see temperatures warm back up into the 60s across the region, those will be the areas that we will have the chance for a strong thunderstorm or two for Wednesday. But the main thing is going to continue to be the rain. Let's give you a look. First of all, temperatures tonight, you can see the 40s north, low to middle 50s south. Temperatures tomorrow not really changing that much. With that front easing southward, we'll probably see fairly steady temperatures, maybe rising a few degrees during the course of the day. Mid to upper 40s across the north, low to middle 50s across the south, with a few readings, Manning, Natchitoches, Sabine, and Natchitoches parishes in the upper 50s to low 60s. Now, as far as the rain, it's going to continue off and on, heavy downpours across the region, which will go on through the afternoon, continue through this evening. We'll see a little bit of a pause late tonight. And then Tuesday, you can see another round of showers and with a few rumbles of thunder anticipated here for Tuesday. I don't expect to see much in terms of any thunderstorms for tomorrow. Mainly going to be rain with, again, some thunder, a little bit of a possibility, but nothing as far as any strong storms or anything like that for Tuesday. Going through Tuesday night, you can see the areas of rain will continue and intensify somewhat, as we are looking at, again, the heaviest rain Wednesday morning from southwest Arkansas into northeast Texas. You can see here across the northern sections of the region, this will gradually work its way south and eastward during the day, with the strongest thunderstorms likely developing over central Louisiana into Mississippi Wednesday afternoon. That is where that risk for severe weather will be the highest for Wednesday. And then we'll see this activity gradually come to an end Wednesday evening, and that'll set the stage for a pause in the rainfall for Thursday, Friday. Again, the main concern continues to be the rain on top of what has already fallen. We're looking at rainfall potential, another 3 to 5 inches possible across the heart of the Architects here, with Futurecast showing a swath of 5-inch totals possible, basically from Longview to Shreveport up to about Willisville in Nevada County. But keep in mind, this could shift anywhere, but it does look like that threat will be highest along the I-20 corridor in East Texas and Northwest Louisiana. As far as Wednesday, I mentioned this, Storm Prediction Center does indicate that enhanced risk basically for central Louisiana into Mississippi. As I mentioned, that's where the risk will be highest. Again, going to have to keep an eye on the southeastern edge of the Architects for the possibility for a strong thunderstorm or two. Really depends on how far back to the north that front moves as that upper level disturbance off to our west approaches. Taking you through Wednesday night, again, the rain will come to an end Futurecast does show quite a few clouds lingering for much of Thursday. We'll probably see the clouds decrease Thursday afternoon as we become partly cloudy. We will see a clear to partly cloudy sky for Thursday night. And then Friday, finally a day of sunshine, a chance to dry out just a little bit. Don't get too used to it. Again, here's that upper level disturbance coming in for a Wednesday, giving us that final round of showers and thunderstorms. It'll clear. We'll see a break Thursday. We'll see a break Friday. And then heading into Saturday, probably Saturday evening, we'll begin to see some showers develop across the region if this particular model is correct. Other models do hold it off a little bit later. So Saturday's rain not yet set in stone. We will see, again, another disturbance carve itself out into the Rockies here by Monday, and that'll serve as the focus for more showers and thunderstorms to end the weekend and begin next week. And we could see this threat linger through the middle part of next week as this upper-level energy will take a few days to make its way through the region. So our very soggy weather pattern will continue off and on for at least the next week. Here's a look at your 7-day forecast. Again, looking at low to middle 50s for both tomorrow and Wednesday. We'll stay in the 50s Thursday and Friday despite the sunshine. Notice Friday morning, low temperature at 30. And then the moisture returns with a slight chance of rain Saturday. Better chance for Sunday, Monday, when we might have a few thunderstorms across the region. You can see a big warm-up back into the upper 60s in Shreveport for both Sunday and Monday. In Texarkana, you're looking at rain for tonight, rain for tomorrow and Wednesday. Not too concerned about thunderstorms for you for Wednesday, as any severe weather will be well to your south and east. You too will see some sunshine Thursday, Friday, and then that rain chance will begin to return to the region again by the end of the weekend and first part of next week. And you too will warm back up to the 60s by the end of the weekend. So again, thunderstorms expected off and on through Wednesday. Best severe weather chances probably will be over the southern edge of the Arkeltex, Sabine and Natchitoches parishes here for the rest of this Monday evening. And that's also the place where we might have a severe thunderstorm or two for Wednesday. But the main story here weather-wise will continue to be the potential for some heavy rain, with 3 to 5 additional inches of rainfall possible from now through Wednesday.